Several crew members of the BRP Teresa Magbanua share harrowing details of their life at sea during their five-month deployment in Escuela Shoal. The Philippine government, meanwhile, insists the withdrawal of the vessel should not be seen as a surrender. Michael Delizo reports.
The BRP Teresa Magbanua arrived at Puerto Princesa Port in Palawan on Sunday. Four of its crew members had to be carried out of the vessel in stretchers and on deck stools. They suffered from dehydration and severe weakness after nearly 5 months on mission at Escuela Shoal. The last month was the most critical, during which the crew only had rice porridge for meals. The ship's desalination unit was also damaged, so they had to drink rainwater as well as boiled water from the air conditioning unit.
May nagsusuka kasi siyempre sir nabigla na iba na yung ini-intake namin, so na-expose kami sa ibang klaseng tubig, which is nung katagalan is nakaka-adjust na rin ng dahan-dahan.
Life at sea is difficult. The signal is weak, so communication with loved ones is limited. The crew on board also faced the possibility of increased harassment from Chinese vessels.
Natakot ako hindi lang para sa akin, kundi sa safety ng buong tao. Pero unprovoked naman sila. So ako, confident ako na walang mangyayari sa amin. Sa dami nila, may mga tugboats na sila doon nagpapaligid.
Another reason why the BRP Teresa Magbanua was sent back to home port was the damage it sustained when it was rammed by the China Coast Guard.
Escuela Shoal is just over 70 nautical miles from the Palawan mainland. According to PCG, the bad weather in the area is the main reason why the BRP Teresa Magbanua was pulled out. In fact, the China Coast Guard and PLA Navy have also left the area and only 11 maritime militia ships remain there.
Upon the return to port, Coast Guard Commandant Admiral Ronnie Hilgavan praised his personnel for what he described as a mission accomplished, particularly in preventing China's reclamation efforts and to allow the Philippines' assessment in the area.
Sometimes there will come a time where we have to choose between the survival of our troops at sea from the perils of the sea and the attainment of the grander goals of the country. We chose to go because we can.
Commodore Jay Tariela, the spokesperson of the PCG on West Philippine Sea issues, clarified that this does not imply that the Philippines has given up on Escuela Shoal.
We did not surrender. Pinull out lang natin ang Teresa Magbanua. Pag sinabi ba natin, nag-pull out tayo, hindi na tayo makakabalik.
Tariela said another Coast Guard vessel will be deployed to Escuela and the Philippines will maintain its presence there, but he did not provide further details.
The Philippine Coast Guard can deploy our vessels anytime we'd like within the vicinity of Escuela Shoal.
Unlike Bajo de Masinloc, which was seized by China in 2012 and where the entrance to the lagoon was blocked, the Escuela Shoal, which spans 137 square kilometers, or the combined size of Manila, Caloocan, Navotas, and Malabon, is reportedly much larger. It also has several entrances.
There is no reason for us to be blocked. We can go to Escuela Shoal with such total area, and it's almost impossible for the Chinese government to block our intent to patrol the entire vicinity of Escuela Shoal.
The National Maritime Council clarified that the Philippines did not agree with China in a recent meeting in Beijing to remove Teresa Magbanua from Escuela Shoal.
Akala kasi ng ating kababayan ay bumigay tayo, no? Ipakindi. Nagmatigas tayo during the meeting sa Beijing. Our DFA stated that our presence will be maintained in the Shoal.
According to a maritime analyst, the Philippines has much to learn from the unprecedented five-month mission.
It's a textbook example of what some will call sea control and how that is achieved. You have secure supply lines, you have to have unfettered access to the area in order to maintain any kind of position.
For maritime advocate and former Justice Antonio Carpio, the Philippines should accept America's offer to escort resupply missions to its ship.
Ginawa na ng ano yan eh, ng Malaysia at saka Indonesia eh. Walang magawa yung Coast Guard ng China eh. Hindi naman nila babanggain yung US eh.
According to the National Maritime Council, the Philippines is seeking assistance from allies such as the United States and Japan for what is called technical coverage in Escuela Shoal and other parts of the West Philippine Sea. Japan will also send desalination units to the PCG. The crew of the Bagbanwa is in high spirits. They say they are ready to return at any time to the West Philippine Sea. Michael Delizo, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro Jr. believes the U.S. could intervene in the country's ongoing dispute with China over the West Philippine Sea. Teodoro told 60 Minutes of CBS News Manila would expect Washington to respond when asked if a Chinese attack on the BRP Sierra Madre would merit American intervention. He says the attack would trigger the mutual defense treaty between the Philippines and the U.S., as he describes the Sierra Madre as an outpost of Philippine sovereignty. Teodoro also said it was none of Beijing's business that Washington sent mid-range missiles system capable of reaching mainland China for the Balikatan military drills last April. He did not confirm nor deny claims Manila will be keeping the missile systems. Former Duterte administration spokesman Harry Roque fires back at a Philippine congressman who tagged him as a fugitive. Roque insists Congress may have overstepped its authority when it ordered his arrest. He says he will challenge any actions which he considers unlawful. A joint House panel had ordered Roque arrested for snubbing its probe into his alleged links to illegal offshore gaming operators.
Hindi po ako pugante. Ako po isang ordinaryong mamamayan, pinaglalaban ang kanyang karapatan. Alam ko po na makapangyarihan ang mga congressmen. Alam ko po napakadami nila. Pero ako naman po bilang ordinaryong mamamayan, may proteksyon. Ang tawag po dyan, ang Bill of Rights ng Saligang Batas at paninindigan ko po yan.
Surigao del Sur Congressman Johnny Pimentel earlier said Roque can be already considered a fugitive after refusing to appear at the hearings of the so-called House Quad Committee. Roque has described the inquiry as a witch hunt. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez apparently taking a swipe at Vice President Sara Duterte. The speaker opened Monday's plenary debates on the proposed 2025 national budget with a speech that calls out individuals who allegedly misuse public funds. Romualdez said they will not tolerate what he calls hypocritical critics of the lower chamber. Duterte earlier accused Romualdez and the House Appropriations Committee Chairperson Elizalde Co of controlling the government's budget. She also claimed the House hearings on her office's budget are scripted.
Hindi maaaring magturo ng daliri ang mga may sariling kasalanan. We cannot ignore the reality that there are those who seek to undermine our work. Critics who speak of accountability while conveniently ignoring their own misuse of public funds. To these individuals, I say, let us be clear. This chamber will not tolerate hypocrisy, nor will it stand idle in the face of such blatant disregard of public trust.
Romualdez also gave assurance the House will ensure the national budget will be scrutinized to guard against abuses and corruption. The House is expected to pass the proposed 6.3 trillion peso national budget next week.
Ang pera ng bayan ay hindi para sa pansariling pakinabang ng ilan. Tungkulin natin bilang mga kinatawan na tiyakin ng bawat piso ay para sa pag-unlad at kapakanan ng ating kababayan. Let it also be known that this House favors no one. We do not bend to pressure or special interests. Walang makakalusot sa ating pagsusuri. Tayo ang boses at mata ng taong bayan at sa kanilang pangalan, tayo ang magbabantay laban sa pag-abuso at korupsyon.
A Philippine lawmaker believes former President Duterte may be charged with obstruction of justice for helping televangelist Apollo Quibiloy evade arrest. Congressman Jill Bungalon made the statement at the House plenary debates on the proposed budget of the Justice Department.
Publicly, sinasabi niya, alam niya kung nasaan po si Pastor Apollo Quibiloy, pero ayaw niyo po itong sabihin dahil ito po ay isang sekreto. So having said that, Mr. Speaker, yung pong kanyang pahayag lalong-lalo na siya po ay isang property administrator ng KOGC compound. So in effect, that would warrant a possible case of obstruction of justice.
The spokesperson for the National Police, meanwhile, says officials of Kibuloy's Kingdom of Jesus Christ and the group's lawyers may also be held liable for helping their leader evade arrest.
Yung angels of death po ay definitely hindi lang siya figurative speech. Existing itong mga tao na ito at may mga ilan na po tayong na-identify na mga pangalan. We will be requesting the Firearms Explosive Office for the revocation po ng kanilang LTAP at firearms registration po.
Police Colonel Fajardo added they are working on disarming members of Kibuloy's so-called Angels of Death. Philippine President Marcos Jr. says he feels a deep sense of shame after the country is labeled as the world's epicenter of child pornography. Marcos made the remark at the summit to end online sexual abuse of children. The president said he was touched by the story of a woman whose child was forced to entertain adult men. The Philippine Interior Department says 169 victims of child sexual abuse have been rescued since January. It urged local governments to pass ordinances to curb the rise of child abuse.
I could not help but shed a tear to think, to try to have to relive the suffering that she went through. And to think how many other children are, even as we here sit in this fancy hotel room, eating our fancy food, continuing to suffer the same fate as she has. And accompanying those tears that I just shed was a deep sense of shame, because we have not done enough.
Turning now to the effects of the recent weather disturbances. Six reported dead due to the southwest monsoon enhanced by tropical cyclones Ferdy and Hiner. The government's disaster management office says the casualties were listed in Mindanao. 11 sustained injuries while another 2 remain missing. The recent heavy rains and floods have so far affected over 86,000 families. Ferdy exited the Philippine Area of Responsibility last Saturday, while Hiner is now a tropical depression. Another tropical storm with international name Pulasan is also forecast to enter the country later tonight. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica.
Good morning, Ms. Bettina, and to all of our audience. So currently, as of 4 a.m., Hiner was estimated based on all available data in the vicinity of Alicia Isabela with maximum sustained winds of 55 kilometers per hour and gustiness up to 70 kilometers per hour. It's moving westward with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour. And because of Hiner, where there is tropical cyclone wind signal number 1 raised over Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands, Isabela, Quirino, Nueva Vizcaya, Apayao, Kalinga, Abra, Ifugao, Mountain Province, Benguet, Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, Pangasinan, Zambales, Tarlac, Nueva Ecija, Pampanga, Bulacan, the northern portion of Quezon, including Polillo Islands, and the northern portion of Metro Manila. We're also expecting enhanced southwest monsoon due to Hiner and the tropical cyclone outside the Philippine Area of Responsibility. For heavy rains caused by the southwest monsoon, we're expecting for today heavy to intense over Palawan, Occidental Mindoro, Aklan, Antique, and Negros Occidental. Moderate to heavy rains over the rest of Mimaropa, the rest of Western Visayas, the rest of Negros Island region, and Bicol region. For heavy rainfall due to TC Hiner, for today, we're expecting heavy to intense rains over Cagayan, Isabela, Quirino, Apayao, Kalinga, Mountain Province, Ifugao, Ilocos Norte, and Aurora. Moderate to heavy rains over the rest of Cordillera Administrative Region, the rest of Cagayan Valley, the rest of Ilocos Region, Nueva Ecija, Bulacan, Quezon, and Rizal. And also, we're expecting Hiner to exit the landmass of the Philippines within the day and exit the Philippine Area of Responsibility on Wednesday. For the update on the tropical cyclone outside the Philippine area of responsibility, it is expected to enter the Philippine area of responsibility tonight and might stay inside the Philippine area of responsibility until tomorrow noon. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Appreciate the report, Veronica. Thank you so much.
Thank you.